show was made possible with the continued support of Online Casino Share. Hello, iGaming people. Jay Todd here with what may be the most ridiculous show the APCW has ever done. And hey, we've had some doozies. This is really a continuation of last week's show, which dealt with the IGRG codes specific to you affiliates. Codes written by a trade group that represents the operators you work for as affiliates. Codes written specifically to terminate your affiliate agreement and steal your players and commissions at the sole discretion and whim of those operators. I really thought there would have been more outrage about that, but hey, it was pretty quiet in the forums. So maybe you're all just so used to being f***ed up the ass over and over again that you just don't care anymore. Still, there is no shortage of horse shit for this week's episode. So, let's get caught up with what else has been going down, starting in what's left of the market in the United Kingdom. As the Betting and Gaming Council, fresh off of their support for those IGRG codes, has another code to help protect players by slowing down slot machines. The real reason that they are going to limit slot spins moving forward to one spin every 2.5 seconds is to cover their own asses before the review of the Gambling Act takes place. Just that simple. And speaking of self-preserving actions masked as player protections, let's return to those same IGRG codes, as some webmasters have reported that the programs they're working with are sending them emails about their social media promotions. Apparently, affiliates must now use hashtag ad clearly and prominently on all such posts moving forward. Note the ambiguity and the interpretability of the words clearly and prominently. And just to make sure you're all being good little boy and girl webmasters, the UK Gambling Commission has partnered with Big Brother Zuckerberg over at Facebook to monitor and limit gambling-related ads. And I'm just going out on a limb here and saying they will probably extend that to gambling-related posts. After all, some of my posts from my website that have nothing to do with advertising, only news from the gambling industry, have already been blocked on Facebook after they labeled them as spam for absolutely no reason. But that's a completely different bitch on my part. Rumor has it that maybe there should be some additional player protections rolled out next year, including perhaps a 30-day waiting period between when a player deposits and when they can actually play. Random urine tests for all webmasters. Find out what we've been smoking. And replacing jackpots with player participation trophies. There. Now all is right with the world.
We'll be right back.
Before getting to the rest of the madness, I wanted to let you all know that Clarion has now set new dates for both their London and Amsterdam shows next year. In what I can only imagine is the purest form of optimism, ICE is scheduled for the 29th of June because, after all, when you think of June, you think of ICE. IGB affiliate will follow on July 1st and 2nd, hopefully concluding with the fireworks display for all us Yanks. Then, in late September, IGB Live will take place in Amsterdam, running from the 28th through October 1st, which may cause some headaches with getting to the G2E event in Las Vegas, but hopefully not. After all, G2E has no specific dates set yet, and I understand Clarion is doing their very best with such a fluid and unpredictable situation. I just hope that we actually have an event in 2021 that I can attend and perhaps find some happiness and a little bit of normalcy. But for now, back to the lunacy. With all these new codes and rules being rolled out in the UK as a pretty transparent act of pacifying industry critics attempting to gut gambling altogether. Naturally, most affiliates are expendable. What, you didn't see that coming? You don't think so? Get caught up. Most affiliates are expendable. If you're a super affiliate, obviously doesn't apply to you, but for all us peons, all the rest of us average affiliates, we're pretty much expendable. And dare I say, most affiliate programs now view most webmasters as a liability, at least in the modern British market. We're just not worth the headache of dealing with us. And all of this under the guise of protecting players and addicts, even though a recent study in Spain concluded that the problem gambling rate was actually just 0.3%. Not 3%, 0.3%, 0.3%. But that's easy enough to ignore in the face of political agendas. What's more important are the inflammatory headlines, such as a link between problem gambling and domestic violence. That's the sort of news that the MPs want and need. There should have been a study on how these increased regulations are actually affecting affiliate income and their families. But someone would have to give a shit about affiliates to actually do that. And we know they don't and they won't. Glory hallelujah, I got another show in the banks. God willing, if my health holds up, if I still have a job and there's an industry to come back to, we'll see you next week. 10 random urine tests for all webmasters and jackpots being replaced by participation all the way to the end. All the way to the very end. And then I mess it up. That's perfect. All right, well, do it again.